Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are probably here because you have purchased or plan to purchase one of our SV series flow sensors. In today's video, I'm going to go over the installation guidelines of our SV series flow sensors. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our SV series flow sensors. In today's video, we are going over the installation guidelines. In this section, we go over the direction of flow, recommended mounting locations, and straight pipe run requirements. So to begin, let's talk about the direction of flow. Because of the vortex flow principle used in these sensors, the direction of flow is important. Therefore, we have an arrow etched on the sensor housing itself that indicates the direction the medium must flow through the sensor. Next, we talk about mounting locations. In a closed-loop system where the pipe is always filled and there are no air bubbles that can form, the orientation of the sensor is not critical. However, in an open piping system, it is recommended that the sensor be mounted in front of or in a rising pipe. And finally, we talk about the straight pipe run requirements. On this chart, we show the recommended straight pipe run requirement in front of and after the sensor, depending on the disturbance that is causing the turbulence of the flow in the line. And finally, one thing to consider is that if the media temperature is above 122 degrees Fahrenheit, there are parts of the housing that can heat up to over 149 degrees Fahrenheit. So we provide a warning label that you can put on the sensor housing itself. So now I'm going to show you how to navigate to the datasheet so that you can find more specific details on your part number. In this video, I'm using an SV4200. So if you scroll to the top of the page, you can enter your part number into the search term bar. So if you enter SV4200, for example, and press enter, you will see a small description and picture of your part number. And if you click on the part number in the orange font, it'll take you to the full data sheet. Here you can find technical details on your specific part number, as well as if you hit downloads, you will find the operating instructions and IO device description PDFs for your device. Finally, if you scroll back up to the top of the page, you'll see a section that says flow meters with display with vortex type technology type SV. And if you click on this, it'll take you to an overview of the SV series flow sensors. Here you will see an orange Learn More button. And if you click on this, it'll take you back to the Learn More section for our SV series flow sensors. And if you click on Setup and Support, you can find your installation guidelines and programming section for the SV sensors. So there you have it. That concludes this Tech Insights video on the installation guidelines of our SV series flow sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at our service center at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.